Welcome to Managing Rate Limits with Okta. What are rate limits? Why do they matter? And what Okta tooling is available to manage them? So what is a rate limit? A rate limit is simply the number of times a request can be made to an API. Many SaaS services have rate limits and utilize them for unique reasons and use cases. At Okta, rate limits are used for service protection, infrastructure reliability, and ensuring that one customer does not generate so much traffic that it negatively impacts other customers. For example, if your organization hits its rate limit, there is a potential for a large impact, like your end users being blocked from signing in. This is why being mindful of rate limits is crucial to a successful deployment. Now let's see some of the new capabilities within the Okta Admin dashboard that can help your organization manage its rate limits. From the Admin console, within the left navigation under Reports is Rate Limits. Within this section is a report overview page that provides insights like the number of org-wide rate limit violations over time and the top violating APIs. Scrolling down reveals the API thresholds per API specific to your organization. This number includes any multiplier you may have received via dynamic scale or override via customer support. You can search, filter, or sort on this table if you have specific APIs in mind or to help highlight problematic APIs. For example, by searching for V1 Authent API and clicking on it, you'll find a detailed page that could help when investigating a rate limit warning or violation. Additionally, this could be used proactively during a new product launch to ensure there is capacity to meet the incoming traffic or general capacity planning. Here are two examples of how the detailed view could be used. Let's pretend you're an admin at ATCO. You had an incident earlier today on V1 Authent where you hit a rate limit violation. You want to investigate what happened. You can see the rate limit threshold has a size of 500 requests per minute, and things appear to be back to normal now with utilization at zero. You can click Help to make sense of the data shown in the graph. The graph is showing you the amount of traffic being called against this API and how many IPs the requests are coming from. Within Help, it states that if there is a spike in traffic, but the number of IPs stays flat, this could indicate that one IP is responsible. Or, if there is a spike in traffic and the bar graph is close to the line graph, it's coming from multiple IP addresses. When you hover over the spike in requests and hover on the data before the spike, it looks like unique IPs stay flat. When you click on the spike, you can see one IP sticking out from the rest. When you click on that IP, you can see the history of it confirming that when that IP spiked, the overall usage spiked. We know this IP is tied to one of our test applications, so now you can reach out to investigate what happened. If this IP was not internal, you would look into adding this IP to a block list. While investigating the previous incident, you notice what seems to be another spike in the timeline graph, so you investigate. This looks unique from the last incident, so you click the Help section for advice. The graph is very similar to the scenario where the spike in traffic against this API is matched by a spike in total unique IPs. Now you try inspecting some points in time both before the increased traffic and during, and what you see confirms the second scenario. The number of unique IPs has increased along with the traffic, but none of the IPs are spiking and are creating minimal traffic, which appears to be valid traffic. Now you can reach out to your Okta representative and request an increase for future events. Let's conclude this demo under the Settings section. For ease of use, The per client rate limit settings are now found under the Settings tab within the Rate Limit dashboard for a convenient one-stop shop for rate limit configurations. Admins can now customize their warning threshold by choosing the usage percentage that they want to be notified at before exhausting their rate limit quota. An email and a syslog event will be generated at that new percentage. And that's your new Okta Rate Limit dashboard. For questions or resources, please visit help.okta.com.